Hello everyone, Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael doing the Trauma Survivor and Overcomer series. And today I'm going to do part one of five, and I'm going to do blame next time, restoration process after that, overcoming or transformation after, landmines, mines, pitfalls, and snares to watch out for. So I'm doing five videos after the, including this one after this, but it's a total of a six video series. And you would also like to go over to the intro, because I've mentioned some things in the intro and I'm not going to repeat myself in any of these videos. So I myself am an overcomer, but I'm also very educated in the field of mental health for 2 decades, also practical work experience in 2 decades of that, a degree in the behavioral science. Is just letting you know what my own background is from the Lord leading me. I've been a Christian since I was 18, and I am a trauma survivor and overcomer, and the education was just part of the process, because you know there's emotional, mental, physical aspects to overcoming this, which I'll be discussing when I talk about the restoration process or the healing process, the recovery process. And I myself, as I said, am a trauma survivor and overcomer. So you have to first survive before you're going to overcome. And so it can actually, depending on the trauma, suicide, murder, any kind of abuse, these principles will work. I'll give you tools and tips. They've worked for me. I've applied them. I've gone through the practical process, so I have the marks of the cross, not just a book learned or whatever. And I don't have a message of condemnation for you. I have good news for you, that if you apply the principles of God, which I started to say in the intro there, you will find that the process of restoration and overcoming will likely be the result if you trust and obey God. Now, sometimes, no matter what you do, eventually we're going to come up to a position, because we're in a fallen world, obviously, that we're not going to be surviving. We're mortal here. And, we don't know the mind of God. The Bible says that His ways are higher than our ways. And if you go to www.biblegateway.com, and Google search suffering, you will often find that word accompanied with the word, or contrasted with the word glory. Because if you trust and obey God, that's where you're going to. God uses suffering and the cross. He says, deny yourself. Jesus' own words. Now you can also Google search this over at www.biblegateway.com. And if you look at Jesus' own words, you can see in the Gospels there that He says that we must deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow Him in order to follow Him into overcoming. Also, I'd like you to refer you over to Job and take a look at that story where he had to overcome the loss of his entire family. And so, you know, what we experience as suffering, tragedy, and loss, frequently God is using to perfect the ones that will come to Him and will allow Him, through trust, giving Him our lives, to glorify us through the suffering, because he uses the cross for glorification, because it crucifies our ego in the process, but it keeps all the gold, the silver, the good, the precious about us, the faithfulness and truth is what that means. Silver represents truth in the Bible, and gold is frequently symbolized likewise as faithfulness. These are the things that God values. We'll have plenty of works. We're not saved by works, but we'll have plenty of works when we come to God. We trust and obey Him, even though He slay me, the Bible says. If you trust and obey Him, He'll use suffering to glory. Why? Because He's a builder. And the universe speaks of Him. If you just look around, you can see how generous God is. Your life may be going into the pit, but you know the God who created all this, He's got no problem. He can manage anything that you're going through, including if it's a personal holocaust like I had in my family. It was like a dominoes effect of suicide, violent deaths, and then following that, all sorts of pitfalls, drug addiction, substance abuse, all sorts of things that led up to even more tragedy and trauma. And so that's why I'm doing these tools and tips, because I've survived the process of restoration and healing and overcoming now towards ministry. That's where I go out and I give people, I impart them tools and tips that I myself am now a part of the message of overcoming through my testimony. And so Where is God is frequently the question asked, and you know, including by myself, when this hit me at 18 years old, my mom died an unknown death, and suspecting that it might have been, well, probably was, you know, just can't be proven, very suspicious death, let's put it that way. The death certificate says death unknown. And so, you know, after that, my brother struggled for 20 years after that, because he'd lost our mom before that as a child. He just could not suck up more loss. And so, you know, he went through all, I'll warn you about the landmines and the pitfalls and the traps in another video, not for this one, but he didn't survive that. Although we did come to the Lord through my testimony as his older sister and always there for him. And so, yeah, finally he ended his own life in suicide, was the end of it. But God can even use that to his glory. And there were a rash of such deaths that went through our family like dominoes, because that's the danger to those types of evil things that come on your plate that you didn't ask for. You know, if you don't have the coping tools of that, because it's so abnormal, and I don't know, I mean, who does, that's just trying to live a normal life, well, that can be very destructive. And so when I get to the landmines, traps, and pitfalls, I'll let you know some tools and tips that I found useful for overcoming that. And the book learning was all part of the process, and learning the Word of God was indispensable. Hiding His Word in your heart is indispensable, the Bible, and having a close relationship with Jesus Christ, indispensable. Both of those things, being led by the Spirit moment by moment through and out of a very actually terrifying and terrible ordeal, along with the rest of my family members, who I was also very, very concerned about as the older sister. You know, that was the role I was scripted in. And yeah, so eventually, I didn't know this, that this was part of also a process that the Lord was going to use to lead me into ministry, which I had no intentions of. I remember when I learned about ministers, you know, I just wanted to be a nurse. When I looked at ministers, I looked way up, you know, way up. I just saw the world of them. Never in a million years did I think that I myself was going to become one, but you know, the Lord champions. If you look around, He's very generous, and He's championing us. He's not creating dependencies on other people, etc., which is frequently an Antichrist tactic. And so, you know, where is God in suffering? Well, if you trust Him and obey Him throughout the Scriptures, you will find, or do what He says, not out of tyranny, out of trust. If you apply His Word, even if you're not a believer, you will find that it will work. You will start overcoming. You still got a problem that you're mortal, though. And He is the King of the Kingdom of God, Jesus Christ. So eventually, and you know, the sooner the better, because we don't know how long we have, and we don't know if we're going to have a repentance ability to repent. So if He's, you know, if He's convicting you now, that is the work of His Holy Spirit. He wants to save you. He came to seek and save that which was lost, which is all of us, the children and all of us. And so where is God in suffering? Well, Jesus Himself went to the cross in love, poured Himself out in order to be the hero and save us, and atone for the sins of a fallen world. We're in a fallen world. We're the ones that are not, we're in the 200 year plants. We're in fantasy, magical thinking land. And when disaster hits, that's when we really start to wake up and find out that what the Bible's talking about, that we do need salvation and rescue, and Jesus is the King and the hero. And yeah, so as soon as you come to Him, the better. So that He can regenerate your heart, save you, and now lead and guide you 24/7 like a mother hen into the abundant life, even in the face of horrible tragedy. And so I'm going to come back and do the next video. This has a habit of cutting off at the end, so I'll just talk a little further here. And the next one I'm going to be doing is blame. The difference between condemnation, and which is from the pit, from the devil, it's only tearing down, and the actual ministers of God coming from God, which will convict of sin but always show you the builders. Jesus is a builder. He's a carpenter. And so His ministers are also builders and overcomers, and they won't just be condemning, but they will be showing you the way toward the way. Yeah, the way to life, the narrow way to life. And yeah, so it's a very life-affirming process, and that's all I have to say for now.